Trey, did I just see you carrying your underpants into the pits just then?
I think you did.
You've even got one of those see-through laundry bags, mate. Right? There was like, everybody kind of looked. Did you feel like everyone was looking?
Yeah, I got nothing to hide. They can see it all. It's fine.
That's the kind of attitude that will take you places, Trey.
Yeah, I know, right?
Good job last night.
Appreciate it.
How does that help your confidence coming back into a place you're always fast at anyway?
Yeah, it certainly doesn't hurt. You know, Grace Harbor's a place that I feel like I run pretty good at most of the time, so it was good to finally knock off a big one there. We usually, one way or another, you only get one outlaw or high limit race a year there, so we haven't done as good as in the past as I felt like we could have, and last night showed how fast we can be there. Another good track for us tonight is Skagit. You know, I think we got a few more cars. It's definitely not going to be easier, but we've got tons of laps here, so I think if we do our part, if we do what we're supposed to, then I think we've got a good chance of running up front, for sure.
How much would that amount of money change your world?
a whole lot.
Would it all go into this thing? Or would you get a new laundry bag at least?
I might get a new laundry bag. It probably more of it would go into the race car than I would think. But it's life-changing. I mean, just winning any of these nights, I mean, last night was amazing.
But, yeah.
Saturday night would be a big one for sure. It's awesome that they're putting up such a good purse. I think this is the most money that any event on the West Coast has ever paid, so that's really cool. And even more special that it's kind of right in our backyard. So, more than anything, I want to do it for, you know, the hometown crowd. I feel like we're starting to build up a really good local program here again, and what better way to showcase than running good against, you know, one of the national touring series. So, it makes it really exciting for us local guys.
There's so many states divided up in pockets in America where they all talk about how tough the sprint car racing is. You know, the Midwest, certainly over east, and you know, in Cali as well, and Texas, and the Dakotas, and everywhere like that. Where does the Pacific Northwest rank in all that?
Yeah, I feel like we're kind of pigeonholed up here in a corner a little bit, so it's easy to kind of forget about us a little bit. But we've got some really, really good talent, especially now that our 410 racing is building back up to what it was, you know, years ago.
Yeah,
we've got a lot of good drivers up here, and just myself running here for the last 3 or 4 years, I've got to see firsthand how much better the competition's gotten and how elevated it's gotten, pretty much due to Skagit and everything they've done. I think a lot of people will be surprised about how good we can do against national guys here.
Is it hard to head east? Is the place so different? I mean, obviously places like Knoxville and Eldora and places like that are different, Williams Grove, but how tough is it to leave this region?
I mean, these tracks are unique. There's only a couple of them up here, right? So, but when I went back east and ran on the bigger stuff, I don't know if it was just eager to get off with smaller tracks, but I actually did pretty good on the big stuff. Either of these tracks, there's nothing really like it. Actually, the only track that I would compare Skagit to would be where they're also running this weekend is Houston's. I think Houston's and Skagit are, having run both of them, they're dang near identical. Couple unique things to both of them, but other than that, you can't really compare it to any other place. Skagit's definitely really unique, so hopefully it seemed to put on a really good show here at the big shows this year, and some of the local shows even have been really exciting, so we're hoping for more of the same for 3 nights this weekend.
You seem to keep your car pretty basic. I like that. Lots of carbon fiber and just sort of a mean sort of look to it.
Yeah.
If someone wanted to come along and put a big nasty logo all over that and give you money, you'd be okay with that, right, though?
Yeah, absolutely. We like the clean look. It's basically just a family operated team, so not a ton of outside backing. We're welcome if somebody wants to slap a big sticker on there. That'd be great. It'd definitely help us out a little bit, but for the time being, we'll keep our mean clean look going.
Good luck with that laundry sack at $100,000 would buy.
Appreciate it.